all the evidence we've gathered to date when we monitor Australia's biodiversity indicate that the pressures on biodiversity continue to increase and our biodiversity continues to decline. That's why it's critically important that we use science and scientific monitoring in order to better manage Australia's biodiversity into the future.
And all the way down the back to this marker.
There's a lack of data on the status and trend of Australian biodiversity in general, but Australia's not unique in that sense, in that many countries would like to have more data on their status of their biodiversity and its change. One of the challenges we always face is that we didn't really collect accurate data at the beginning of the change process, and we don't have good accurate estimates of how many species are in Australia. We believe there are something like 500 or 600,000 species of animals and plants and microorganisms in Australia. Probably only about 25% of those have formally been named by scientists. We're aware of many, many more, but they just haven't received the attention they deserved in terms of scientific naming yet. And there are many, many other ones out there that we believe exist, but we don't have accurate records for so far. It's definitely the case that monitoring Australia's biodiversity has become much more important in the last 5 or 10 years. Scientists in Australia studying our biodiversity realise that we need much more accurate information through robust and well-designed monitoring programs. One of the important ways that Australia is addressing the knowledge gap in biodiversity monitoring is through the Atlas of Living Australia, which is delivering digital information from the plant and animal collections in Australia on the distribution and abundance of Australia's animals and plants. So that's a great initiative that allows for members of the public and scientists to go and view places where plants and animals in Australia occur or did once occur. So that allows managers greater understanding of the geographic distribution of Australia's biodiversity, a much greater access than ever been available before. Large-scale monitoring programs for Australia's biodiversity have begun in the last few years, especially with the Terrestrial Ecosystem Research Network, which aims to provide on-ground and satellite indirect monitoring of Australia's biodiversity in a number of key biomes throughout the continent. So that's a really exciting investment by the Australian government in monitoring Australia's biodiversity. The National Flying Fox Monitoring Program is a good example of a single species monitoring program that gives you an understanding of the complexity and expense of monitoring a widespread species like that properly. So on a particular day each year, over 500 different flying fox camps from Cooktown right down through the East Australian coast are monitored, and individual flying foxes are counted in each of those camps. So that's a tremendous effort from a lot of scientists and volunteers, and that needs to be done over many, many years to understand the trend in the diversity and abundance of those flying foxes. And the national biological collections and the other collections in Australia are critical resources for research on Australia's biodiversity. They allow us to compare new species that we might discover through monitoring and survey work with species that are already known to exist here and have names. And they also to allow us to assess the abundance of species through time. And in some cases, they allow us to look back in time at genetic diversity. So there are a couple of good cases now of researchers being able to assess past genetic diversity by examining specimens that are in Australia's biological collections. It's certain that in the future, the monitoring of Australia's biodiversity will incorporate many more genetic and genomic techniques into their armoury of tools. Genetic techniques enable us to gather a lot of information very quickly now on the diversity of Australia's plants and animals, and this provides us now with a wonderful and very powerful tool for assessing and monitoring Australia's biodiversity in the future. Australia is one of the world's mega diverse biodiversity countries, and it has a very high level of biodiversity, particularly endemic biodiversity that's only found here. We're lucky that we have a well-developed infrastructure for science and natural resource planning. We're very well placed to use information from the collections through the Atlas of Living Australia, new genetic technologies and really sophisticated new monitoring programs to adequately assess, monitor and ultimately manage Australia's biodiversity much better into the future for future generations.